Make an extraordinary journey.
I know nothing of the Great War. I have seen the photographs of muddy trenches. I've heard the stories of the dampness that seeps into the bones, the big black rats. I know of the casualties, the gains and losses. But that war is not my war. Of that war, I know nothing at all.
The Officer's Ward, dramatized by Mike Walker, from the novel by Marc Dugain. With Geoffrey Stretfield as Adrian and Megan Dodds as Clemence.
Be careful. Look after yourself. And write to me.
Don't be upset. It'll all be over in a few weeks. Your husband?
A friend.
What section?
The infantry, like everyone else. What about you?
Engineers. Going to join my regiment.
Well...
I know it's not done, but what about... I could take a later train. What about a drink? I mean, there is a war and...
Yes. Why not?
I'm an engineer. It's not exciting, but I was the first in my family to go on to further study. And you?
Music. I play the piano. I hope to play the piano professionally one day.
Thank you. Cheers, then. I don't know Paris. I only started working here last year, and then the war and...
It's vile. An obscenity, this war. Disgusting. I can't tell you how... what I feel about it.
I think I know what the rest of the customers are feeling. And it's not you they're going to tear apart.
I'm sorry. Come on, let's leave. It's all God, you know.
God?
Faith, can't you see? If men didn't believe in eternal life, they'd never be so keen about fighting and dying.
Forgive me, I don't think it's God. I think it's the Germans.
You would say that.
I'm not a believer.
But you are going to fight.
Not today. Not for a while, I'm sure. Maybe not at all. But it'll all be over soon.
And what are you going to do now?
The young man you were seeing off...
He's very talented. A violinist. One wound to his hand.
Do you love him? I'm sorry, I had no right to ask that.
Yes. Yes, I do. But perhaps you'd like me to answer the question you haven't asked. What about me? Isn't that what you wanted to ask? Well, what about you?
Look, forget this in a second if you want to, but the war might last weeks, maybe months, and for that time I'll be surrounded by men. The only women I'm likely to see are nurses. It would be nice to think that I could spend these last few hours with you. With all respect to your prior commitments, of course.
You have a flat?
Yes.
Then take me there. Adrian? Don't you think fear increases desire until it's almost unbearable?
I might be able to answer that in a few weeks' time. But I don't really think that someone who's just been bayoneted is really...
You know I don't mean that. Not physical fear, something else. It's something vague, intense inside you, just there. And I'm gone.
Oh, I don't know. I build bridges, that's what I...
Stop now. Be quiet.
Clemence, I have to go. I leave you the apartment for as long as you like. When you go, drop the keys through the letterbox. And please, leave your address for me to find when I come back. I want you to know how much you've begun to mean to me. Take care.
Engineers?
Fournier, Colonel Duchesne. Get over to the canal, will you? I want your opinion on the bridge.
Are we going to advance, sir?
If the bridge will take the weight. It's up to you, Fournier. HQ wants a full report by 2100 hours tonight.
Very good, Colonel. Corporal, get a couple of men surveying equipment. Truck.
Find me some level ground, Corporal. Leclerc, check those girders. Rusted the helm.
These ones, sir.
That's it. See if they move.
They move all right, sir.
That's enough. Don't want to bring them... Is that their artillery? Corporal, you'd better... get the men under some...
Days before they moved him. Then they brought him here. Six in all, I think. They didn't want to touch him.
No.
Not while they were moving him.
The first of its kind for us. Full of pus.
Mud.
Hmm?
Mud. Stopped the lingual artery from bleeding. Saved his life. Poor sod.
What?
What?
That's a new break. Risk of gangrene through infection of the wounded parts.
Infection to airways and pulmonary regions due to lack of protection. Anemia? Feeding. We need to...
Keep him strapped down. Still. And get him to Paris.
Clean the wound.
As much as possible. It stinks. So feeding. Get him to Paris, let them deal with it.
God almighty, what a stink.
Well, what do you expect? Give that one some water, will you?
Yeah, what about this one?
No, I don't want to risk it. He'll be all right till tonight. Let them decide.
Bloody hell.
Keep this pace out of the rain, Mark.
That's okay, poor bugger probably needs a drink. I mean, he won't drown, will he?
Dunno. I mean, he's like you, isn't he? Can't keep his mouth shut. Are they expecting him?
Yeah, I suppose so. Hello? Ass?
Bloody stairs. I thought he'd be lighter somehow.
Yeah, well, B-double-O-T, mate. Bloody officers on top.
Quiet, please. We don't want to disturb the patient.
On the bed.
Please, and with care.
All right. Yeah, what...
Yeah, not a bad billet, this. Could stay here myself.
I don't think so.
No, maybe not. Need a coat of paint. Yeah, I mean, you can see where they moved the pictures.
Not pictures. It was a mirror.
Good day to you, Lieutenant. No, don't try to speak just yet. Not feeling too lonely, I hope. I'm afraid you'll soon have some company. Tonight, perhaps. Tomorrow, soon enough. No, not in too much pain, I hope. Hmm? No complaints? Yeah, I'm sure you're not a complainer. Good. Now, do you mind if I sit down? Now, this is what we want to do. We're going to feed you. You have to build up your strength, blood and bones. Trust me, we're right up to date here. Then, in 2 or 3 days, we'll operate. Put things back in a bit of order, eh? Rest.
Yes.
A lot of rest. Not in too much of a hurry to get back to the front, I suppose? Yeah. Well, if it does drag on and you do go back, it'll be with a different face. Brand new face, eh? I even guarantee your moustache will grow back. You did have a moustache. Most of you young fellows seem... I'll be along to see you every morning. We'll give you a slate and chalk for writing until you're able to talk. Slate? Hmm? Chalk? Yes? Yeah. Well, you're lucky, you know. Face, but no complications. Very good vascular capillarity. No gangrene, contrary to what the old school used to think. You've only two things to worry about. Breathing well and eating well. Nurse?
Yes, Doctor. Yes.
3 meals today, tomorrow, then nothing Wednesday. We'll operate at 6 in the evening. If there's too much pain, you can give him some morphine. Don't let him get used to it. We won't have enough for everyone if it gets... This goes on. Well, Lieutenant, I'll see you again soon. I'm sure we'll get to know each other well, eh? Yes, we have a way to go together. Good day to you.
Let me help you up, Lieutenant. That's it. I'm going to help you eat. Just you wait a moment and I'll wheel the trolley. That's better. Now, I'm going to use this little thing. We call it the duck's beak. Because it looks like a duck's beak. And if I can just... That's it. In it goes. Here, and we can get some soup in. Good. That's good. Well done, Lieutenant.
Find me some level ground, Corporal. The clerk, check those girders. Rusted to help.
These ones, sir.
That's it. See if they move.
They move all right, sir.
That's enough. Don't want to bring them... Is that their artillery? Corporal, you'd better get the men under some...
What are you doing, Lieutenant? You should try not to interfere with the wound. Just stay as still as you can for now. Please try not to move your tongue. There's nothing... It won't help at present. And Doctor says you shouldn't try to speak yet. Use the chalkboard if you have to. Would you like the chalkboard? No? Perhaps rest is better for now.
Ah, Minister, I'd like you to see Lieutenant Fournier.
Hmm. Knocked about a bit, eh?
Wounded on the Meuse in the very first hours of fighting.
Lieutenant Fournier, I'm here to express the country's gratitude for your bravery and your sacrifice. Without men like you, the land of our forefathers, which we must hand on to our children, would be under the sway of German barbarism. We are proud of you. Where are you from?
Oh, he can't speak yet, Minister.
Very good. Be brave, Lieutenant, and feel proud. Damned proud, because we are proud of you.
Thank you, Minister. Now, we must be getting on. I know there are a lot of people who would like to see
us.
Yes.
You
can come this way. We'll...
You see, Lieutenant, you're up. Think you can walk a bit? Good. Good. Bravo. Good for you. You'll be running soon. Oh, do you want your board? Oh, the other patient. He's a pilot. Went down on the Marne. Oh, yes. He was on fire. Well, you can see that. Hasn't come round yet. We're waiting. Poor chap. Face like a big toffee. Poor chap. Doctor is waiting. And you mustn't tire yourself, Lieutenant. Remember your operation tonight. Want to be ready for that, don't we?
Sam's nurse. Watch the capillarity. Let's clear away the... Yes. Swabs. Good.
What about you?
We're making progress. You're out of danger. But we still have that hole to deal with. The truth is, Fournier, I'm waiting for material to reconstruct your upper jaw. In particular, your palate. The only method we can use is bone graft. We need the bones of a child.
Oh, yeah.
I've informed my civilian colleagues, and as soon as the raw material, if you'll pardon the expression, is available, we'll begin work. I must be off. I'm operating at 5 tomorrow. Did 10 as well as yours today. What? Something? Please send someone to your flat. Is that it? Your flat? See if key or message. Well,
if it's that important to you, Lieutenant, one of the orderlies could go, but I can't promise when. We are busy, you understand.
Yes, old man, as soon as we can. I'm going to get some sleep.
The passage.
No.
It makes a mirror, Adrian, look. Time to look into the glass. No.
Please, Clemence, I can't. Not yet.
Fear and desire? Now! Well then, there you are, Adrian. After all that, it's simple. Just a man with a tunnel in the middle of his face. Just that. Only that. A rabbit hole.
Ah, Lieutenant. Your commission. Your apartment key. One of the orderlies was able to go. A key and a letter for you. Always good to receive letters, I hope.
Adrian, the moments I stole with you seemed to me all too brief, but so intense. I surrendered to those eyes that give your face such an impression of strength. I'm sure it was the mad atmosphere of that day that made us both surrender. You knew, you know, I am committed to another. It would be madness to see each other again. Goodbye. Your Clemence.
But what are we now, Clemence, except faceless men in the kingdom of the mad?
Yes, Lieutenant? Your things? Oh, there are lockers in the corridor. I suppose your things will be there. Oh, that's all right. Are you going to finish what the Germans started? The
pilot is Captain Vale. Engine caught fire, then he crashed and was thrown out of the plane. And there's a Lieutenant of Penonstaire arriving this afternoon, and lots more, to tell the truth. And doctor says they've got the bones of a... some bones, they can begin grafting. I think he's arranged your operation for the weekend, Sunday. No days off for any of us now, I'm afraid. Oh, Captain Vale, you're awake. Now, I'm going to change these dressings.
Clémence. I will see you again. One day, somehow, and you will change. Time will blur and alter your beauty, and I will stay the same. My face will never age.
Stillborn infant. Colleague sent the bones, coated in petroleum jelly. Well, should do the trick. At least the beginning of the trick. Quite a coup, really, for us. First of its kind graft of an upper jaw. If it works. Obviously, we have to count on 2 or 3 months for the graft to take. If it does, well, we'll see what we shall see.
So, it starts again.
My head. It hurts, it hurts. God, it hurts.
It will get better, the pain, or you'll get more used to it.
No, never, not without morphine. Closer, more distant, closer, closer still, then it goes away. Ah! Oh.
It will go, everything goes in the end.
Nothing. Just stop the pain, now, please, now.
And the others, don't they hurt too? Those faces that are not faces. The only thing that shows they are not upside down is the position of the eyes, when there are eyes.
The standard bandage has no eye holes, so those lucky bastards will never see what they don't have.
You think they are lucky?
Clémence! Don't go!
Vale. Captain Pierre Vale. Flying Corps. Damn near flying corpse. Oh. How's it going? Graft taking, is it? Don't know what they're doing half the time. Look at this. Bloody Italian graft, they call it. Grafting? My arse. Oh. Actually, my bicep. Ever seen anything like it? Cut open your arm, fix it to your face, and hope the damn skin grows across. Been mending noses since the time of Christ, they tell me. Crap, I tell them. Lieutenant. Adrian. Engineers. Pleased to meet you. Can't shake your hand. Tell you what, when it takes and I let my arm down, you can shake my nose. And a proper Jewish nose, I told them. Something to get a hold of. Talking of which, that little nurse who empties the bedpans, a redhead. What do you think? Not at all, my friend. It's not looks. It's personality. In fact, I'd put money on it. This face, charred meat out the oven, it means nothing. An advantage. I'll have her by the end of the week, you see. You just see.
Good morning, gentlemen. Lunch call. All of you who can stand can queue, please.
Well, I have to admit it. I'm just not ugly enough for her. Beauty and the not very beastly beast. Still, give us time, eh?
Morning, gentlemen. Lunch time. Now, come on. If you can stand, you can queue for me. Have your bowls ready.
So, the bone graft's not taking, old man. Those doctors. I think they try things out for the hell of it. On us. For the hell of us.
Good morning, gentlemen. Yes, it's soup again, I'm afraid, but it's very good soup. Now, those of you who can stand, can queue, please. Come on, Captain Vale. Just for me.
Go for a walk round the building, Fournier. Get out a bit. Most of the nurses know us now, and the ones that don't. Oh, how long is it since you made a pretty girl squeal?
Good morning, gentlemen. lunch call. Now, remember, doctor says that queuing is good for you. Keep on the move. Have your bowls ready.
Nurse, come over here. This is my friend Fournier, and he's going to show you something you'll never see with any other man.
What the hell did he do to her?
Poor girl. First time she's ever seen a man's tongue waggling at her through his nose hole.
Good morning, gentlemen. No jokes today, if you please. It's lunch call. All of you who can stand can queue. Yes, Lieutenant, that means you. And have your bowls ready.
I've worked it out, Fournier. Over the last 13 months, we've each eaten something like 785 bowls of soup with chopped-up meat. And I, for one, am getting thoroughly fed up with the stuff.
Lieutenant, the lower jaw is loosening up a bit. Pity about the graft of the upper, but I've some ideas on that. We'll try another operation later, but at present I'm thinking about something to take the place of the palate. A prosthesis. Rubber. That's the stuff. Separate the sinuses from the mouth cavity. Get you talking, Fournier. Talking, eh? It won't be perfect, but then we don't live in a perfect world. Let's see, shall we? See what we can do.
Ga 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 ga. Ka 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 ka. Ya. Da 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 da.
So, the engineer has a voice. Well, quite something, old man, to be able to speak again. Give you some teeth back soon, I dare say. That'll improve things. No more bloody soup.
Da-da-da-da-da.
No more getting out of arguments with Henon Stair and me.
La-la-la-la-la. Na-na-na-na-na.
So now you have friends.
Vale and Penon Stair. He was the third arrival in the ward. We have our beds in a row, and we...
And now you have a voice.
Yes, we can talk, and talk, and
well,
talk.
They've taken to sending the young ones up here. They were misbehaving too much with the ordinary patients. Ha! Talk about into the lion's den.
A Jewish pilot, with his crisped face.
Nonsense, man. You should set an example of calm fortitude and pray. Always prayer.
The devout Breton aristocrat, with half a perfect profile and half a lump of fused flesh and bone.
But if prayer were a bridge...
And myself.
If prayer were a bridge, would you drive a cart over it?
The secular republican from the Dordogne.
What was that?
If prayer were a bridge, would you drive a cart over it?
Of course. There's no point in faith without trust.
No point in being stupid either, my friend.
Ha! And that from a man who spent half his days in the clouds.
Ah, but I came back to Earth again. With a bang!
Friends, then. And what brings you together?
Our decision to reject introspection and avoid thinking about the disaster of our existence.
Because
that would lead to bitterness, made up in part of disenchantment and in part of the martyr's selfishness.
Then goodbye, Adrien. I must go.
No, Clemence! I need you!
Your friend.
Clemence, please!
Goodbye, Adrien.
I'll find you. I swear I will. I'll get out of here and I will find you.
Nine, I think.
You must have a method.
Not at all, old fellow.
A lot of practice. Family's been gambling for 500 years.
Still mine.
Gentlemen, a word. You know I like to stroll around the place.
Go on.
On the top floor, there's a small ward, a special ward, for generals and others of eminence.
Not many residents, then.
None, so far as I could see. But the nurses keep going in and out.
For a smoke?
For a patient.
Mm-hmm.
A woman.
What?
A woman? Like us?
I've only seen her once. Slim, fine figure, and, yes, old man, like us. Eyes and mouth beautiful.
Oh.
The rest... Nose, cheekbones. Like us.
A woman? Do you realise it's 2 years since I talked with, even sat beside, a woman who wasn't a nurse? Is she a lady?
A lady, to be sure.
Think of that.
Then we must... Surely
we
must...
We can't descend on her all at once. We'd frighten her.
True. We need a plan.
One of us. It must be one of us first.
But who? It's a delicate mission.
Penancère. If you look at him from the left, why, he's almost what he was.
Decadent aristocrat.
I don't know. And from the right, he is what he is.
Which you couldn't say for you or I, Adrian, old chap.
Well?
Well, I'll do what I can, my friends. Now, are you ready to lose some more money?
A woman.
Isn't that what we're fighting this war for? France, our women and children.
And yet here, in this place, a woman. In some way it brings home our failure. And yet...
A woman. Stop primping, man.
It's my duty. After all, we must present ourselves as officers of the Republic... Warriors,
do be quiet, Vale.
Gentlemen, may I present Marguerite Lavelle?
My pleasure. Vale, Pierre, Air Corps.
Fournier, Adrian, engineers, and very glad to make your acquaintance.
Gentlemen, you are too kind. I am afraid I cannot hear what you say, but I know it was most gallant.
Marguerite is deaf, gentlemen. As you hear, she can talk quite easily, and she can, of course, read lips.
Ah! And you canny bugger, you're the only one with a complete pair of them.
But of course. Marguerite tells me she enjoys a hand or two of Belote. I have taken the liberty of inviting her to join our game.
She can't come in our ward, surely.
There is an annex off the General's ward.
I have lots of room, gentlemen.
Then what are we waiting for?
I was born in Lyon. Well, you know what these towns are like. Provincial. We had all we wanted. I had all I wanted. Suitors, parties, excursions. Everything a beautiful young woman could want. And yet, when the war came, all my suitors seemed to find some vital reason why they should not join up. The same with my brother. Things were to go on as always. Parties and excursions. But they couldn't, you see. I couldn't let them. For the first time in my life, I began to think about what I was here for. What it was all about. My trick, I think?
Yes.
Of course.
Please. Go on.
They were short of nurses, so I joined up one day. I just did it. Persuaded one of my suitors to get me assigned to the frontline medical unit. It was odd. I wasn't frightened. I cried a lot. I was sick. But not frightened. And I did begin to do something useful. Until one day, a shell landed on the tent. Everyone died. Except me. I think this trick is yours, Captain.
Yes, of course.
I haven't told my family yet.
Yes. Families and those we love.
Poor La Rochelle.
La Rochelle.
I'm sorry.
A young fellow. Been with us, what?
2 years.
2 years. Wound like Adrian here. Family man, wife and two children. Came to see him at last. Wife and children. Asked a nurse to buy him some sweets for the boys. I didn't recognize him, you see. Children crying, "Not my daddy." Wife takes them away, says she'll come back again when La Rochelle is more himself. More himself. Came back to the ward, not a word. Went to bed, didn't wake up. Killed himself. Priest didn't want to say mass. A suicide, you see. We had a word with him, made him see it our way. Afterwards, we... all three of us swore. Never. We'd never do that. Not suicide. Ever.
No. Not suicide. Ever.
You know, we should all get out a bit more.
He says we should go out.
If you will forgive me, I cannot yet.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Lieutenant Fournier? Lieutenant, you have a visitor.
What? Give us our trespasses.
Who?
Your sister. She presented herself at the door.
Good Lord.
Aren't you pleased?
Yes, of course, only I've been writing to them at home, and...
And?
Can't you tell her I'm not feeling well? She'd come back in a few days.
But I said you were on top form. She seemed so worried. She even asked if you'd lost an arm or a leg. I told her not a bit of it. You were intact.
Intact? How long we've all been here. Very well.
Well? What then?
Ah, oh, poor thing.
I felt like vomiting. I trembled.
He says he felt like vomiting. He trembled.
Hurry up, the nurse kept saying.
Hurry up? She's waiting for you. She's so excited.
I swore to myself I would keep my dignity, not be upset.
He would keep his dignity, not be upset.
And then?
I saw her from the end of the corridor. Florence, she'd put on a beautiful dress just for me. It was too late to protect her. It must have been the hesitant way I walked that caught her eye first.
Adriel.
She lifted her hands to her eyes, then came to me and collapsed against my chest. We stayed like that. Like two lovers waiting for a train that would take one of them away. She was a girl when I left. Now she was a woman. And we talked.
And they talked.
Then she went. She promised to come again. I don't know if she will have the strength.
She recognized you. That's something. When I went home, I was a stranger. They recognized me, but they didn't recognize me. I was no longer... Marguerite. Marguerite was beautiful. I wasn't. Marguerite was dead. As for you, miss, you may have a room here if you wish when you leave hospital. I told them, I do not wish.
Then what will you do when you leave?
Are you leaving us, Marguerite? What will you do?
I'll find a room of my own. Here in Paris. I'll go back to nursing. And no, my friends, I won't leave you. I have a feeling that none of us will ever leave the others. Not if we can help it.
Ah, that's the spirit. We shall... What's that?
What does it mean?
What? What?
We're hearing bells. Cheers. My lord,
it must be the end. The war must be over.
Armistice, Marguerite. The war is finished.
For some, but not for us. For us, a new war begins. The war of the world we must conquer, or be wounded again and again.
She is right, you know.
Eh? Are you dealing, or...?
About the new world. We can't hide here forever.
It's true. And we must take a first step.
What?
We must confront the eyes of women who are not nurses. If we don't do it now, we'll never do it. This is the moment for action. It is not the time to be caught up in the moral framework of the bourgeois.
What exactly are you suggesting?
A visit to the nearest brothel. In my mind, this is a sacred duty. Are we agreed?
But, my friend, look at us.
There is nothing more pitiless than the eye of a prostitute. Her customers see her as meat. How else does she see us? Meat. A trifle overdone in some cases, not particularly well carved in others, but meat nonetheless. Are we agreed?
It all seems very respectable.
This is France.
I never.
This will also be an educational experience for you, Lieutenant. Let's go get, as Petain might have said.
Bloody things. Never come undone proper. Certainly not you about a bit, didn't they? Still, you're lucky. My brother got killed.
Oh, yes, I suppose I am.
Well, anything special you'd like? Or shall we just get on with it?
You see, I'm just with my friends and, well, since we have a little time, perhaps we could talk.
Old fellas mostly want to talk. You old, then?
No, it's just that I...
To tell you the truth, since your mouth ain't working very well and the other obviously is, why don't you just get your money's worth? I mean, I'm not so bad to look at, am I? All right?
Yes. Why not, after all? Why not?
Sura.
Thank you.
It's always the same when you're having a bad time. You think you've been through the worst. You've endured all that a man can endure. But you're wrong. There's always something else. All we needed was syphilis, and we've probably got that now.
Well, old man... You know we're not going to lose touch.
That will never happen. Adrien, my friend, I'm going to miss taking your money. I
will play again. I'm getting my revenge and my money back.
Good luck, old man.
Good luck to all of us.
Well, my friends, just think. All the women who've been waiting for us out there for 5 years.
And where are you bound, Adrien?
My uncle invited me to recharge the batteries, his place in the country. Why not, after all? Sit in a wicker chair under a cedar of Lebanon and stare.
Wicker chair under a cedar of Lebanon and stare in wonder at all the comings and goings of the house. My nieces are hardly out of their teens. and I hope they'll get used to my face in time. And long Sunday lunches under the trees for me, my friends. And if I can't taste the food or the burgundy, well, I can pretend.
And then, well, there's life and there's work.
There speaks the engineer.
There speaks the optimist.
Ah, monsieur, come in.
Good morning, Monsieur Grouchard.
Would you like a cigarette? Can you?
Smoke? Yes, I can, thank you. I've come to see you about starting work again.
Yes, I had no idea you'd been so wounded so severely. Verdun, the song?
The Meuse in 14.
Sorry, I didn't quite catch that.
The Meuse, 1914.
So long. Those damn Boche don't do things by half. And how long before you recover?
I have recovered, sir.
You have recovered. Forgive me. Yes, and you wish to start work with us again?
At my old job.
Only money, you see. Certainly there's reconstruction, but there's no money for these big projects. And Monsieur Plissard, you remember, he was unfit in 1914. He's more or less running, as it were.
As it were, the department, and in short, we don't need you. Goodbye.
The man's a pig.
I shall write to old Nally. He still owns the firm. Lost a son at the film. He might understand.
Come and work with me. Building planes for the future.
I know bridges, not planes.
The best of them both fly.
Maybe I will. Let's see how it goes.
And how does it go, Adrien?
It goes from day to day.
I had a letter from Penonster. He's starting an organization. For us. For those like us and Marguerite.
Yeah, he would do that. He would either become a monk or... Here's to him.
Here's to all of us. To flying and building bridges. Another.
Can't stop. I have a concert. Foray Requiem.
What's that?
Foray Requiem.
Me, I preferred you.
Taxi! Taxi!
I say, that's my cab.
I'll take the soldier.
Try to stay with that cab, the one the lady got into. Don't lose her, please. It's vital.
Cop in.
Last week, after we met?
Yes. At the concert.
I've known you 4.5 years, and I've never seen you like this before.
She... Well, she meant... She's what kept me sane. At least for the first couple of years.
Are you crazy or what? Adrien, you're my friend. I know what you feel, and I'll be blunt. It's a luxury you can't afford. Stop now. Talk to Penonster. He'll tell you the same thing.
I have to talk to her. Tell her...
Tell her what?
That I still love her. After one night, yes, stupid, but...
Look in the window. Look at your reflection. What do you see? The hero, yes. The handsome fellow you were. Eh? Listen. My design is almost finished. A mail plane. It's the future. Flying the mails. Come to my place tomorrow. Have a lunch. Have a look.
I can't. I have a date already. By the river. That's where she walks. She doesn't know it, but I'll be there.
Then...
Be careful, dear. Don't slip.
He's sure-footed, the child.
Hmm? Oh, sure-footed, yes. She is. Excuse me, have we met?
The first time you didn't have the strength to turn me away.
Adrien?
Yes. Though not quite all the man I was.
If I'd known...
We had all we needed. And there was only your letter in hospital. It was clear enough. I've thought about you a lot in the past 5 years.
How did you find me?
The concert, Foray. I just wanted you to know that despite appearances, I'm still the same.
I'm so sorry.
What happened to you when you did?
Died at the front, 1914.
And it's my turn to be sorry. Your daughter? How old is
she? She was born in August, 15. She's not yours.
I would have given a lot for her to be a link between us.
I'd like so much for you to forgive me.
It wasn't you who fired the shell, Primrose. Besides, we had already separated. I see that now. The woman you were, you are not.
I'd like us to... remain friends now that we've found each other?
I don't know. We were never friends before, not really. I just thought it was that way for a while. And I have three friends. Two men and a woman who've been through the same things I have. We're a sort of club. We may argue from time to time, but nothing will ever tear us apart. That I know for sure.
After her father died, I tried to get in touch with you again. I wasn't sure of the house number, but I remembered the floor. I wrote a letter and a friend delivered it. You never got it, obviously.
What did it say?
I apologized for the note I left and gave my address.
And why did you write it?
I simply wanted to see you again. to feel the same attraction I'd felt before.
All I can offer you now is repulsion.
Why try to hurt yourself more?
No, you're wrong, Clemence. We survivors, we have come to accept reality. We know it as few other men and women ever will. To survive, we must see with absolute clarity not only the world, but ourselves in it. And yes, in that spirit, I do accept your friendship. And besides, I have to thank you.
What for?
For saving my life.
I don't understand.
In another place, another time, maybe with even another Clemence.
And there it ends, in the park, in the snow, by the river, as it began. My war. The war to end wars. Except it doesn't stop any more than life stops. It is 1925. I've got my job back and got married. She's just 19. I'm 34. Her father is a Polish Jew, her mother excessively pretty. She is kind to me. She listens to me. She seems frail, but she is strong. And as I found when I asked her to marry me, brave too.
Well, there's hope for us all. You lead the way, Adrian. It is something quite extraordinary. The first of us to marry, it is...
It's life, my friends.
And you, Marguerite?
No, not I, Adrian. A soldier, a man, yes. A disfigured woman is something the world cannot deal with. I'll be alone. I know that. Until I die.
Alone? With your three musketeers? Nonsense.
Nonsense indeed. We are, as always, Marguerite, so very much at your service.
Then God bless you all. Now, Adrian, got your wife. She is waiting.
By gosh, she is, eh?
1926. Penelstair has married, and, refusing to be outdone, Vale follows.
Gentlemen, we have entered a great period of normalization.
1936. We live in the present. Men who fear nothing because they have nothing to lose. Our detachment impresses everyone. We are taken for wise men, but we are not.
Adrian, over here.
Wine?
Brandy. I need one.
Oh?
A German officer offered me a seat in the metro. I almost... The war to end war, eh?
Never trust a slogan, Adrian. Here.
Good to see you two again, at least.
Not so good, old man. There's trouble.
As well as being invaded by the Bosch?
I'd like to think it has nothing to do with me personally, or my family. I mean, I can't see how they'd go for a man who's had his face so well flattened for France, but there you are.
I don't understand.
We have to get Vale and his family out of Paris today.
Hmm?
They're rounding up Jews.
But who...
Our own people, old man. Frenchmen. Obeying their German masters.
Then let's get on with it.
I have a fast car. It'll mean leaving most of your possessions, but once we get to my estate, you and your family should be safe.
Even the Germans would be embarrassed to suspect an aristocratic hero with a ruined mug like you, my friend.
I can't believe that men like Vale are to be killed for being what they are. But it is so. We get him and his family to Penelstair's estates. They are safe, but thousands more are lost. And the war passes, and now there is another peace. For Penelstair, a lasting peace. November 1945, only weeks after the Vales emerge from their hiding place at his chateau, he dies. He is accounted a hero for his untiring work with the disfigured, and France has sore need of heroes now. We are all here, old comrades from the officers' wards, and Marguerite too, and many younger men. Some with bandages round their heads, others with their wounds open to the air, faces that are no longer faces, the marks of a war that was never meant to happen. They advance, intimidated by us older men. There is sadness in their eyes, those that still have them, and I lean towards Vale and ask,
what are we going to do now?
We're going to teach them how to enjoy life. Eh?
In the Officer's Ward, dramatised by Mike Walker, from the novel by Marc Dugain, Adrian was played by Geoffrey Stretfield, and Clemence by Megan Dodds. With Alan Cox as Vale, Nicholas Rowe as Henri de Penelstair, Maxine Peake as Marguerite, Poppy Miller as Florence and the Nurse, Jonathan Keeble as the Doctor, and Don McCorkindale as Grishar. The Officer's Ward, directed by John Taylor, was a Fiction Factory production.